All right, now we have covered all the different rules for exponents, so I'd like to review them and then talk about when we have to use them in combination. Is there a particular order? Does it matter? Is one way better than another? So let's see. I'm gonna remind you of these in my own order. I wanna remind you of the power rule. The power rule says if you have x to the a, raised to the b, you get x to the ab. Next, I'm going to look at the product rule. The product rule says if you have x to the a times x to the b, you get x to the a plus b. The quotient rule says if you have x to the a over x to the b, one on top of the other, you get x to the a minus b. The negative rule says if you have x to the negative a, that is 1 over x to the positive a, or move me. There's also the zero rule, which probably will not show up in our combination, but the zero rule said that if you have x to the zero, it's equal to 1. There is a little disclaimer: as long as the base is not zero. 0 to the zero power is undefined. All right, now as you see a complicated expression with exponents, this is the order I suggest you use. This is not like, please excuse my dear Aunt Sally, where it is a firm algebra order. This is a suggested order. 1, 2, 3, 4, and I don't think you're going to have this one. So let's see if we can simplify. The first one, I have x to the 6th times x to the 7th over x to the 8th. Can I use the power rule? No. Because the power rule, I would have parentheses, power inside, power outside. Product rule, which is second. Yes, I have a product on top. That's going to be x to the 6 plus 7, or 13, over x to the 8th. Next, do I have a quotient? A quotient would be up and down, and yes, I do. That's x to the 13 minus 8, which is 5. Do I have a negative exponent? No, so I'm done. So please remember, power rule, then product rule, quotient rule, take care of negative exponents last, if there are any. Number 2, I have p to the 4th, p over p to the negative 5. Can I use the power rule? No, I don't have parentheses, exponent on the outside. How about product rule? Yes, I have a product of p's on top. This has an implied exponent of 1, so that will be p to the 5th over p to the negative 5th. What about now the quotient rule? Yes, this is a quotient. That's going to be p to the 5 is on top, subtract negative 5 is on bottom. Now you have to be careful because people have a tendency to, I don't know, add those, I'm afraid. But you have to put 5 subtract negative 5. Well, using the subtraction rules, minus minus becomes plus, and this is p to the 10th. You could have done the moving and you still would have gotten p to the 10th. But be careful, the quotient rule when you have negative exponents. Now, I have m to the 2nd. In parentheses to the 8th, times m over m to the 8th. All right, the rules, power rule, yes, I have the power rule here. That's going to be m to the 2 times 8, which is 16, times m over m to the 8th. Product rule, yes, there's a product, that's an implied 1. So on the top, I'm going to have m to the 17th over m to the 8th. What about quotient rule? Yes, that's going to be m to the 17 minus 8, which is 9. And I don't have a negative exponent, so I'm done. You can do the rules in different orders. I just recommend this order. Okay, now I have x to the third. That's messy. X to the third, y to the eighth, raised to the negative 3 power. I can use the power rule. That's going to give me x to the negative 9, y to the negative 24. Power rule says to multiply exponents. Do I have a product of like bases? No. Do I have a quotient up and down of like bases? No. Do I have any negative exponents? Yes, I have that factor and that factor. That means it's going to be a 1 left on top, x to the positive 9, y to the positive 24. All right, let's look at a few more. Here I have a to the 7th raised to the 7th over a to the 9th raised to the 8th. Can I use the power rule? Yes. I have a to the 7 times 7 is 49. And on the bottom, I have a to the 9 times 8, which is a to the 72nd. Now, what about product rule? No. What about quotient rule? Yes. I'm going to have a to the 49 minus 72, which is negative 23. Now, do I have a negative exponent? Yes, I do. And it says, move me. I end up with 1 over a to the positive 23. All right, a few more. Number 6, things just moved. I have negative 45 a to the 8th b over 9ab to the 5th. Now, I'm going to go ahead, if I go through the rules, I do not have the power rule to use. I do not have a product of the same base on either the top or on the bottom, but I very obviously have the quotient. All right, the quotient of negative 45 and positive 9 is negative 5. Then I have a's. I have a to the 8 minus 1 is 7. B to the 1 minus 5, which is negative 4. So I use the quotient rule, and now I notice that this factor has a negative exponent, so this will be negative 5 a to the 7th over b to the positive 4. Negative exponent says move me. My exponent is then positive. All right, next one. I have a to the negative 6, b to the 3rd, all raised to the negative 8th power. Can I use the power rule? Yes. That's a to the negative 6 times negative 8 is 48. B to the 3 times negative 8 is negative 24. Do I have a product rule of like bases? No. Do I have a quotient of like bases? No. Do I have any negative exponents? Yes. Move that factor, and I get a to the 48th over b to the positive 24th. All right. Last problem, I have x to the negative 1, y to the 5th, over x to the 3rd, y to the 10th, and this entire fraction is raised to the 2nd power. According to the order of my rules, I should use the power rule first if I need to, and I do need to. This is going to give me X to the negative 1 times 2 is negative 2. Y to the 5 times 2 is 10 over X to the 3 times 2 is 6. Y to the 10 times 2 is 20. Product of like bases? No. Quotient of like bases? Yes. So I'm going to have X to the negative 2 minus 6, Y to the 10 minus 20. I've seen over the years of teaching, many students make sign errors with these unless they write them down as subtraction problems. This is going to be X to the negative 8, Y to the negative 10. Negative and negative gives me negative 8. Positive and a negative, I subtract, keeping the sign of the larger. These both have negative exponents, so both of them say move me. That's going to leave me with a 1 on top, x to the positive 8, y to the positive 10. So I got to use the power rule, the quotient rule, and negative exponent rule in that problem. So I hope that you will write down this order of rules and use those to help you with the more complicated problems.